What's up, guys? Francisco here. So first off, thank you so much for the support you've shown for the launch of this channel. It really means a lot to me. Second, I've got a little bit of a flu, but I still wanted to shoot some stuff, so apologies if I sound or look like a zombie in this video. Third, let's talk about picks. Picks make a huge difference in a player's tone and feel. And you could say I'm a little bit of a pick snob, because over the years I tried so many, from the most common ones to the most obscure boutique brands. After lots and lots of trial and error and first-hand experience, I definitely found that my favorites are on the thinner side of things. But let me explain you why. So let's suppose this is the string. This is the pick. If the pick is too thick, it won't bend itself when it crosses the string. Not even a little. This results in the pick dragging the string for a little bit before it finally surpasses it. The thick pick will be like, get away from me. And then it finally will surpass the string. This dragging causes added resistance because of the thickness of the pick. But even worse, it makes the string go out of tune more and more, especially if you're a hard picker like me. A clear example is the brrrr sound of the string being dragged out of the center, which wouldn't be as drastic with a thinner pick. On the other hand, a thinner pick will bend itself a little, so it will be easier to cross the strings. But if it is too thin, let's say 0.5, 0.6, I personally find that while it has a lot of attack and sparkle, kind of loses a little bit too much slow end and meat in the tone. But if you go too thick, let's say 1.4, 1.35, 1.5, I personally found that you start having too much slow end and not enough attack in the highs. So in the end, I personally found that 0.73 and 0.88 are my personal favorites, which keep the meat and the firmness of the low end, but still have a lot of attack in the highs, so that's the best balance for me. I personally use 0.88 for recordings because to me it just sounds perfect. And if that's not enough for you, just know that Master of Puppets by Metallica and pretty much all the Pantera records have been recorded with 0.88. And I use 0.73s for live shows and lessons because it's a little bit thinner. I feel it gives less resistance to my right hand, so in the long run is less tired. And also it makes the strings don't go out of tune as easily. If you do a lot of teaching like me, or you play live a lot, or you just play a lot in general, this does matter. And it's little things like this that actually make a big difference in the end. Also, I know some of you might be like, hey, but what about the pick's size? What about the pick's material? Should I go for a bigger pick? Should I go for a smaller pick? Well, this and more will be answered in the next episode. So that's it for today, guys. If you liked this video, please give it a thumbs up. Comment down below what you would like to see next. And last but not least, subscribe and make sure to activate the bell button so you don't miss any of my future uploads. Thanks for watching, and I will see you guys next time.